Starship Presentation 2019 Recap. My name is Felix, and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? First of all, I want to thank all of those who joined me on the live stream, who did comments, who asked questions, who did super chats, and last but not least, who became patrons. You make hosting this channel worth the while, and without your support, all of this would not be possible. So thank you very much. Now, Elon Musk did his annual Starship presentation on September 28th, and I pulled an all-nighter to give you a stream until 5:30 in the morning my time. It was awesome. We all had a blast, and now comes the recap of the presentation for all of those who couldn't watch it live, so let's dive right in. Starship and Super Heavy overview. Most of us must have waited for this update to happen for at least the last 8 to 10 weeks or so. SpaceX does this every year, and these Starship update presentations are to communicate updates, important changes to the project, and the latest scheduled changes. SpaceX wants to inspire the audience about space and the goals SpaceX wants to achieve. As Elon Musk put it very well, it's all about the things that make us want to get up in the morning. Do we want to have a future amongst the stars, or do we want to be confined to Earth? And the one thing needed to get to the stars is a cheap and reusable way to reach them. This is where Starship comes into SpaceX's plan. A rapidly reusable rocket. It is fundamental for us to be able to travel further and reach those new frontiers. Elon Musk communicated this many times again during this presentation. Starship's number one goal is to reduce cost of traveling into orbit and beyond. And even the first rockets SpaceX built were following this goal. From Falcon 1 to Falcon Heavy, the goal has always been to get a reusable rocket with a quick turnaround time. The big challenge here is to get all the parts of the rocket reusable. With a traditional upper stage, this is very difficult, maybe even impossible. That is why SpaceX is trying to build a radically different design with Starship. Super Heavy and Starship are two separate machines, building a symbiosis to achieve a common goal. Where Super Heavy is more like a traditional Falcon 9 rocket, just super-sized, Starship is something new. Some compare it to a space shuttle. This at least is correct on the return to launch site aspect. That's mostly all they have in common though. Musk showed us again how Starship will re-enter into a planet's atmosphere. It is going to come in at a 60-degree angle until its speed is low enough. Decelerated by its fins and shielded by crack-resistant ceramic hexagonal heat tiles, it soon starts to fall like a skydiver, correcting its descent with its back and forward fins. Elon Musk emphasized again that the design decision to go from carbon composite materials to 301 stainless steel back in October of last year was the best they ever made. This special steel has the same effective strength as carbon composites at cryogenic temperatures and has a much higher melting point in the upper temperature ranges. Where carbon fiber gives in at 300 to 400 degrees Celsius, 301 stainless steel starts to melt at 1500 degrees. Its strength-to-weight ratio at cryogenic temperature in fact is at least the same or even slightly better compared to carbon fiber or aluminum lithium. This enables SpaceX to in the end have less weight compared to a composite material build, as shielding on the leeward side is not needed at all, and shielding on the windward side can be very thin. It is also much more cost efficient, as a ton of carbon fiber material comes in at $130,000 per ton, whereas a ton of 301 stainless steel comes in at $2,500 per ton. Steel is resilient to the elements, enabling SpaceX to build Starship in the open, which is not possible at all with carbon fiber or aluminum lithium. Steel is easy to weld and can even be reused as a possible building material on Mars. SpaceX changed the design to two fins on the tail of Starship coming from the original Tintin look three-fin design. This was chosen due to the fact that two fins and separate landing legs seem to be lighter than three fins with integrated legs. Starship, as it is planned right now, will be capable of lifting 150 tons into orbit eventually. The first commercial versions will be around 100 tons lift capacity. As development continues, the 150 tons will be the end goal. Starship will have three sea-level Raptors and three vacuum-optimized Raptors. With the sea-level version at a specific impulse around 350 and the vacuum-optimized version with an aspirational target of 380. These are very good numbers, making the Raptor engine a very capable engine for the Starship project. Super Heavy is designed to have up to 37 Raptor engines if needed. In fact, the engine design will be modular. meaning that you can add or take out engines as needed. It will have up to 7,500 tons of thrust, which is a little more than twice the thrust of a Saturn V rocket. In total, the liftoff weight will be around 5,000 tons, giving the rocket a thrust-to-weight ratio of roughly 1.5, which is very high for a traditional rocket, but very much needed for a reusable one. It will have a propellant capacity of 3,300 tons and will have actuating grid fins much like the Falcon 9 boosters, and the fins on the tail section are just for landing legs. They are not supposed to provide any guidance or stabilization. The question here is if flip-out legs like on the Falcon 9 wouldn't be lighter. A possible explanation for the fin legs could be the weight of Super Heavy. Flip-out legs might not be able to take the force inflicted on them on touchdown. Musk also again talked about the key importance of orbital refueling. The plan is to have a Starship launch into space and a second tanker Starship being launched directly after the first launch. This tanker Starship then is supposed to refuel the first Starship in orbit. This enables Starship to get 150 tons of payload, be it cargo or passengers, to Moon and Mars. In-orbit refueling is a vital part of the whole concept. SpaceX has already learned how docking in orbit works by gaining vital knowledge with Dragon missions to the ISS. Musk stated that docking two Starships in orbit would in fact be easier than docking a Dragon capsule to the ISS. The second part, as mentioned, is complete reusability and a quick turnaround time. Starship is supposed to be fully reusable with low maintenance required. It's supposed to support rapid production and installation. Right now, the total capacity of Earth-to-orbit cargo is 200 to 300 tons if you combine all the rockets in the world. With a fleet of Starships, this could be raised to 1,000 times more, as each Starship can carry 150 tons to orbit and in very rapid succession. Musk showed some impressive scale references. Here you can see the hopper we already saw flying compared to a Millennium Falcon from Star Wars, a Starship, and a Starship and Super Heavy stacked. He also showed the launch structure for scale reference, and we could see the huge flame diverter system under the rocket. The large launch structure will have a crane system on top for quick stacking of Starships and Super Heavy boosters. Development schedule updates. Elon Musk showed a beautiful video of a Raptor engine firing, and production scale is supposed to ramp up on Raptor engines significantly in the future. Where SpaceX is building roughly one Raptor per 8 to 10 days right now, they will ramp up to a couple Raptors in the same time in the near future and a Raptor per day in Q1 next year. The main constraint on building Super Heavy is engines, as it needs many of them. So Super Heavy Mark 1 and 2 will be built after Starship Mark 3 and 4. Development is hard to predict, but Elon said that it will move very fast. 1 to 2 months to do the 22 km flight with Mark 1. The next flight after that might be booster and ship to orbit already with Starship Mark 3. Which will start building in about a month in Boca Chica. Ships and boosters will be built in Boca Chica and at the Cape as fast as possible, and we should expect to see multiple ships lined up in the future. Elon said that Mark 3 and beyond will even be built faster and that the material will be thinner and lighter. Mark 2 will already be built in a month or two. Mark 3 in 3 months from now. Mark 4 in 4 to 5 months, with orbit being reached at the latest with Mark 4 or 5 in less than 6 months. All these numbers, he said, are accurate to within a few months. And he emphasized the internal competition again. Both places will launch crewed missions. Elon also said that Mark 1 will do the flip maneuver on its first flight. So that should be an incredible sight, as the Raptors will actually overshoot Starship on landing, having to correct it again. Mark 3 to 4 will do a transition from cold gas to hot gas thrusters, as cold gas thrusters have a very low ISP of a bit above 60. With a Methalox thruster, you can easily get a specific impulse of 300 without any cooling. This will greatly improve Starship's maneuverability. Musk again stated that he intends to use solar power on Mars for fuel production. So against all the speculation going on, solar still seems to be his primary idea for a main energy source. Mars will be completely renewable. Finally, one of my favorite theories received some more proof. Musk's other companies definitely have use cases for Mars. Boring machines can be very handy on Mars, and a Tesla could be operated on it as well. put a different chassis on top and add some life support and it might make for a great Mars rover. And the solar cells can come directly from Solar City. That was a massive amount of information given out by Elon Musk and SpaceX, and I want to take the opportunity again to thank SpaceX for their openness and for the unique opportunity to follow such an interesting project so closely. This is very unique and very much supported by the whole community following your project. So this wraps up today's episode of What About It? Did you watch the presentation live, and what do you think about SpaceX's very unconventional take on how to build a starship? As always, tell me in the comments. So here we are again at the end of the episode, thanking all those patrons for the huge amount of support given to me and the channel. Without your help, the whole undertaking would be impossible. This is to all the thinkers, moderators, idea givers, and helpers out there. Thank you very much. Everyone, please give a warm welcome to John Stockbridge, Captain Future, Gordon Pierce, David Kutzler, Miko Koskelin, Gary Albert, Cro-Magnon Grams, Jake Brownson, Keith McKnight, Mars or Bust, and finally, the craziest ever patron name in What About His History, Electricians are Master Rays, Welders are Knuckle Draggers. You rock! Thank you for watching this episode of What About It? If you liked what you saw, remember to like and subscribe, as this helps me the most. Feel free to hit me up on my Patreon page so I can get additional help in doing more and better content, as this gives me the time to focus on what I love doing the most, to give you the latest and greatest about space and science. I hope to see you on the next episode. Until then, have a great time. Yeah, I pulled an all-nighter. Ah, yeah. Ah. Most of us must have... Elon Musk committed... he committed himself. A ton of carbon fiber. And one separate landing leg. Musk... it was incredible.